Well, I figured since I had a bunch of TIG welding to do, I'd go ahead and give this a try. I bought this a little while back. I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with Jodi on weldingtipsandtricks.com. If not, look him up. Man, that guy's got an awesome collection of videos on welding and everything like that. I'm not going to demo any welding with it. You can go look at his stuff. He's awesome. Anyway, I bought the kit. I don't remember how much it was, stuff like that. It's on his website. And what it is, it's the Stubby gas lens kit. Okay, so this came in it, hazmat sheet, MSD sheet, basically. This also came in it, you know. But you open it up, and that's basically the gas lens there. You know, it's got a screen, so it diffuses it and everything. It's supposed to allow for greater stick out from the tungsten and stuff like that. So part of the reason why I got it is because my torch, and actually, let me just show you the machine. All right, there's the machine. And this is a Chiry, Chinese. They're imported under a bunch of different brand names and stuff like that. And I bought this years ago. I'm not sure whether or not they still have this same model or anything like that. TIG 200 ADC. This is what it is. It's actually a lot of bang for the buck. I want to say I paid $900 for it, maybe $700. I don't know. Complete guess at this point. I don't remember. Anyway, I've been playing with pulse and stuff like that doing this because I wanted to use the hand trigger instead of the foot. Just because when you're standing, for me, it's just more comfortable. Anyway, that is it. Let's go back and look at the torch. I want to see if all this stuff mates up. All right, this has a WP-26 on it. There is no particular brand name with it. It's what came with it. My understanding is it's supposed to be TECO compatible. I'm not much of a welder, so I'm not extremely familiar with much of this stuff. Oh, same diameter, same thread pitch. O-rings look to match up too, so. Okay, and that goes down and tightens the collet. Now, obviously with the short one here, you're going to have to break or cut the tungsten. I have to resharpen quite a bit because I'm just not that good. So I may end up leaving the back on here. But with the, you see how long, you know, this shield is compared to that one. You know, that ought to make it quite a bit nicer. I was using a really small one here. I was using a 5 on this collet because what I was doing at the time, I needed a really narrow nose on it. So 3/32. Oh, wow! The heat has warped it, and it quit. It's pinched in now. There's no more spring to it, which is why it's been so hard for me to get the tungsten in and out. There we go. That might help a little bit. Okay. So, oh, and underneath here, there's three tungstens here too. I'm not quite sure exactly what sizes they are. It looks like an 1/8 inch. Oh yeah, 1/16, 3/32, 1/8 of an inch. So I'm using 3/32 here. So I'm guessing that's the middle one here. 3/32, okay. So those two, now there's a difference here. See, these are flat, whereas these have this cone coming in. So that cone goes in there and seals to the weight collar. That's not really gonna work well with that. So, oh, that just pops right off. Cool. Well, hopefully, put the collet in. Yeah, that gives you an idea too. See the difference in length of collets. About 3/4 inch difference there. Obviously that's way too long, but I kind of wanted to get an idea here. Yeah, I think I can pretty much cut that one in half. Because that's about where I would want the tip. Yeah, I cut in half easily. Okay, basically I took that, instead of getting one of the new ones out from under here, that one was a blue one anyway, which I don't remember the color. And it looks like he's got a bunch of different ones on here for other options you could have in here. I'm thinking it's 2%. Well, maybe it's the 1.5 lanthanated. I'll have to look that up. Maybe I'll look it up and be able to put it in the... add it in when I edit the video. Anyway, basically what I did is I took that other one I had and I just spun it in the drill and the grinder until it ground itself in half, and then I gave each end a point. Okay? So that way when I'm welding and I screw a tip up, I can pull it out and put another one in. One of the nice things about the gas lens, you're supposed to be able to stick it out further than normal, so I guess we'll see.